Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Swiss Dota 2 Championships. My name is Morality Clause, and today I will be casting the game Swiss Incredible Rebels versus Rhino Gaming. Unfortunately, Rhino Gaming did forget to put their logos on before this match, but bear in mind that Rhino Gaming are the dire the today. So, without further ado, let's go to the picks and the bans. Swiss Incredible Rebels have banned out the Leshrac, the Queen of Pain, and the Storm Spirit, all obvious bans, really. Leshrac just because of his strength, and also a slight respect ban because of last game. Queen of Pain has been dominant throughout the meta, and throughout last meta as well. She's been a very frequently picked up mid. Storm Spirit has been the snowball hero. Now, what have they allowed to slip through? Well, they've allowed an Undying and a Slark to slip through. Undying, you don't want Undying to slip through the cracks there, and especially not in this kind of situation. And the Slark is also a very, very, very hard hero to contest against. You need to make sure the Slark dies early, and if he dies a lot, make sure that his advantage is not... Make sure he doesn't even get an advantage. Now, Swiss Incredible Rebels are picking a very standard lineup. They're picking a Crystal Maiden, they're picking an Earthshaker. These two heroes are very good supports. They're squishy-ish, the Earthshaker not as much as the CM, but they can prove their worth, especially the CM with her mana, aura, and frostbite. And the Earthshaker just if he gets good fishes off and good echo slams. Now the Bristleback is somewhat of a
10 seconds to go.
He's a very good pick, actually. It's a Bristleback. He's got the strength, he's got the quills, he can just start Quill spamming you down if you really need to, if you really start following him with the Bristleback, and since they don't really have any dedicated heroes that can really get rid of him, other than the Undying, which can reduce his strength, they really need to watch out, as well as the Bristleback is also a natural counter to Undying.
10 seconds to go.
No, actually. Yes, I believe he is, and no, he is not, unfortunately. That was actually changed in the last patch. I was getting my patches confused. Now,
reserve time.
The Rhino Gaming's team does look pretty solid. They have an Undying, a very good early game hero. They have a Slark, a very good hero in general. He's very good ganking, he's very good at playing solo, but when he plays with a team, he can also be amazing as well. A Bounty Hunter, well, yeah, that is pretty good. A Bounty Hunter, it can be pretty good in this situation. The track gold giving so much to the enemy team. He's underpicked, in my opinion. He's a hero that's somewhat underplayed because of his just because that his main resource is invincibility equals invisibility, if you want it the other way around. Invisibility equals invincibility, which is not true at this kind of level of play. If he does it well though, he'll be able to do some pretty nice plays alongside as well, you know. So the old, good old courier trick, waiting for the courier in front of the Radiant base, or just the random base, in front of the Radiant base, yeah, and sniping it, basically denying the mid laner of his bottle pretty early on. Now, Lion is also solid support, a very solid, has a stun, has a hex, he can keep people perma locked down, and versus a Bristleback, that hex is going to be invaluable. Hopefully he can get it off. Now Zeus as well, he's got the nuke damage, and to be honest, this is something they need. They have a lot of, Dire has a lot of squishies. The nuke damage from Zeus will be able to kill off a lot of players. Slark, for example, even in the early game is incredibly squishy. A good gank from Zeus will force the Slark away, or kill him or force the Slark away. Bounty Hunter, suspectable, whatever. He's basically, okay, Bounty Hunter's weakness is definitely Zeus's nuke damage, and Lion will just blow up. Undying will be a problem, however, I do believe that the nuke damage will be enough to kill off Undying as well. Zeus just has to play the mid well, which is going to be harder. It's not actually going to be that hard, it depends who he's going to lane against. If they give Undying an off lane, no, they're going to give Bounty Hunter the off, Bounty Hunter could roam. They're gonna go maybe go dual lane with the Lion and the Slark, and give and go Undying solo lane with another mid laner. That's gonna be picked up here. They banned out the TA. Swiss Incredible Rebels did so. That's not going to be a valid mid laner now. 10 seconds on the reserve time. Let's see what SIR pick, sir. Pick as their last hero. Okay. They're going to do Juggernaut Crystal Maiden. Something that works very well on pubs, but in pros could end up working against them. To be honest, I don't see how it could end up working against them. Juggernaut is very good. Healing Ward is spot on. If you can do, if you can place the Healing Ward well, I'm going to guess they're going to take a level on Healing Ward, then it's going to be pretty strong. Blade Fury is very strong. Blade Dance is a very good crit. And Omni Slash is just the magnum opus of Juggernaut. It's why we all play Juggernaut, really. Now, if I'm going to guess correctly and these two are going safe lane, then Undying will be going solo lane. These two versus the Undying?
Reserve time.
I feel like Undying loses out. I mean, Juggernaut can just purge off the decay, I believe. Is it? I mean, Juggernaut does cause magic invincibility. Does it purge off decay is my question. It doesn't from Undying, of course, but does it purge it off from Juggernaut? I am not sure. So we'll see. We'll see how that works out for them. And of course, the Earthshaker might be backing up the Zeus, might be hanging around mid as he sometimes does and backing up the Zeus, waiting for kill potential. Bristleback solo offlane? That does make a fair degree of sense. Now it all depends, really. I mean, the Bounty Hunter, it depends. I think the Bounty Hunter's gonna go roaming. It does seem to make a fair degree of sense, especially versus a CM and an Earthshaker. Make sure those two are pleasantly harassed. Also keep the courier down at the beginning. Now, what will Rhino's final pick be? Let's hope it's something good.
10 seconds to go.
They have 5 seconds on their reserve timer. And they will pick a PA. Okay then. That means Juggernaut will be forced to pick up an MKB if this goes late, and it does mean that Rhino has the late game in their pocket. Although Bristleback does kind of make it a bit more on Sir's side. It's going to be an interesting late game. It depends on if the PA goes down first, but she probably won't. It also depends if the Undying can go down before the PA can start dishing out a disgusting amount of crit. The Stark's going to be annoying in the late, of course, with the Essence Shift, but we'll see how Sir play this out. Yeah, this is going to be an interesting match. Sir's problem last time was that their draft was just completely failing against the draft of Rhino, and in this case, I don't think that's so much the case as it could be. It's going to be an interesting game. It depends on who wins their lanes. It depends on who manages to get the key items first. Depends on who ganks more. So I will be presenting Sir this time. First on the Bristleback, we're going to have Umi online. On the CM, we're going to have Cactus with his lovely, lovely Arcana. On the Juggernaut, we're going to have Innocent with a Juggernaut set I don't really like. On the Zeus, we're going to have Virfel. And last but not least, on the Earthshaker, we're going to have L. And now for Rhino. On the Undying, we're going to have Arkosh, who's going on the offlane, so my suspicions were confirmed. On the Bounty Hunter, we're going to have Axor. Hang on a sec. Axor. There we go. On the Lion, we're going to have MTZ reprising his support role. On the Phantom Assassin, we're going to have Loco reprising his carry role. And last but not least, on the Slark, we're going to have Fimo. Both teams pinging out the runes. Bristleback is waiting for them to ward. In fact, he's actually doing it pretty riskily. He is walking right up to the rune. He's going to be in for a nasty surprise. He's going to be in for a very nasty surprise if Lion can rotate around. They've already got two wards up here. Dire have one to block the camp and the other one for just general vision. Will Umi online get the bottom ward rune? Hacksaw is already there.
The game is on.
And no, well, Hacksaw did get the rune, and Umi online is now backing off. In fact, it looks like he might be in a bit of a situation here. He's going to start quill spamming and running towards the Zeus. He needs help quick. And in fact, Rhino will back off instead, and it looks like they're going to go for an aggressive tri-lane here. In fact, this is going to be another it might just be another aggressive tri-lane from L, Innocent, and Cactus. Who will now, in fact... are going to start protecting the Juggernaut on the solo offlane. They really want that. Ooh, Emmy! Getting killed off by Arkosh and Haxor. Tombstone was dropped. But I believe Innocent is going to have a good lane up here. Fimo is going to get levels, of course, that's inevitable. He's a solo laner here, but it's going to be harder for him. What is Umi doing? He's going up against an aggressive tri-lane. He can't afford to make mistakes. Lion is actually rotating back to top, so this is going to be a quasi-dual lane. A Janada strike going in. In fact, they want to go in on Umi again, and it's going to be pretty hard for him to back off. It's 10 seconds till Tombstone, so if anything happens there, Fimo, wrong end of the Fisher. Probably rating him for that. Now, Umi is going to have a tough time on the bot lane. He's already level 2, so it's not that bad. He's got Bristle backups, but it's still an Undying and in fact, Slark just rotated. Oh, they switched out lanes. Okay, they want to punish this aggressive tri-lane. Arkosh has in fact hit, so yeah. Undying does punish aggressive tri-lanes if they get in too hard. In fact, did he just get double decay? He just got double decay, and Innocent's going to have to watch out here. Yeah, this is not something Innocent wants to take. Now, Fimo is just going to... They just switched out for solo lanes here. In fact, Haxor is waiting on the backline for the bottle to be delivered, which is going to happen. Oh dear, you don't want this happening, guys. This is going to be a problem. This is going to be a very big problem. There it comes. Haxor sees it. There you go. Bottle has been denied. And Riffle is on his own here. He's actually going up against a mid PA, which is not something I expected, but it does work. This aggressive tri-lane here is going to... They're going to have a hard time here. MTZ is actually... Oh, once again, wrong end of the Fisher! Oh, this is not good for Sir. And now the Tombstone is up. And it looks like they're actually going to take a huge amount of damage from this Tombstone. MTZ is going to live. In fact, he might actually come back to get a counter kill. Oh, Cactus is low. This is not good. Ooh, L is going to probably die here, trying to save Cactus. And will Cactus die? Cactus will die. This is a double kill going the way of Rhino. L, your fishes are off point. You can't let that happen. You can't let your fishes be like that. And it looks like they're actually going to kill Verfel here as well. He's going to end up in a bit of a situation. Although Loco, is he diving? Nope, he'll just dagger him to death. It's 4-0 for both teams, and Leftwolf is going down to 2,000. 4-0 for Rhino Gaming. Sir, this isn't good. You're not doing your best here, are you? Let's see what items Akosh has. Not too much, but he's got 900 gold, so he's going to get his arcanes pretty soon. You do what you get. Ooh, that's a lot of items on the curry, actually. Axel's going to get quite a bit here. He's going to get quite a bit rich. Yeah, just got a lot of deliveries. That PMS is definitely going to help him out with the damage. 6 agility is good on the bounty hunter. And it's also going to give him a nice amount of damage, meaning he can dive ever so more. It looks like it's exactly what they're going to do here again. The second buffer goes a bit forward. There we go. Verfield's probably end up dead here. And Slark kills off CM on the bot lane. Umi trying to go for Fimo here. But Fimo looks like he's already going to run off. He doesn't have level 6. Actually, he doesn't have level 6 yet. Cool spray. One more. Umi will back off. Radiant's Kuro has respawned. So that's the bottle up for Zeus. And it's so late, though. And Innocent has not been last hitting well. He's 10-5 versus 17-1 on the Undying. Now, it's 3,000, nearing 4,000 gold net worth for Rhino, and it's 1,500 XP salvageable, and it's slightly going up. That's already 6 kills after 5 minutes. It's what, 1.2 kills a minute. It's not very good for Sir. especially now that they the rotation from Rhino really effed them over, let's just put it that way. Excuse me. So yeah, now Fimo, however, does not look to be in such a good situation down on the bot lane. And now Virfil is pushing in a bit harder. Does Loco have ult? He does in fact have ult, so... Ah, Bounty Hunter getting a kill on the CM. Tombstone was dropped. Bristleback getting return kill on the Slark though. There, Healing Ward is up, so they're going to try and counter here. Healing Ward is down. In fact, he's going to start spinning, and MTC might be in a bit of a situation here. MTC in fact goes down. Pretty good kill from Innocent, and now there's a TP reaction in coming in from CM. Oh, nice kill. Getting the Bounty Hunter, and Akosh will be the next one to fall. That's a triple kill going the way of Serb. However, they do lose the Earthshaker to a final DK.
That's four in a row.
And PA getting Bristleback's head on the bottom lane. I'm sorry, I missed that. PA has been farming herself up pretty well. If we look at net worth, she's already to top on net worth. It's 2,600 for the Undying. Innocent's trying to hold on, but he's at 1,000 off the PA. He's doing the best he damned can, but it's not too easy. They need some TP reactions now, you know, if they want to save Virfil here. And it's not going to happen. He's been critted. Oh, nice fish up! And the TPs are there. Innocent, does he have Omni Slash? No, he does not. These TP reactions are completely worthless now. Ooh! Will Haxel see him? Cactus. Nice freeze on Hax. The Haxel. Will he kill Haxel? No, Haxel actually goes invis. Last second invis there. Ooh, they see Haxel. But this is a lot of commitment for one Bounty Hunter. TP in from Virfil. No, Haxel's backing off. What are they doing? It's four man for one Bounty Hunter. You're committing way too much. Back off. He's gone. Accept it. Not there. He disappeared. Secure the room for Virfil. Rotate back top. That's a lot of wasted time. Time they don't have. Start grabbing the illusion room from bot lane. And it looks like they want to go right back in on the Bristle, who now has level 2 Bristleback. But that's still not enough to slop what's coming for him, and there you go. Fimo is the first one to go in. Here's the PA. Undying, meanwhile, killing Earthshaker on the top lane. Tombstone was probably dropped for that. Bristleback dying off to the Slark. Yep, Tombstone was dropped. Earthshaker now dead. So this is Rhino's game. Rhino's game for sure. They are 4,000, leading 4,000, heading to 5,000 on net worth. 2,000 leading to 3,000 on XP. Not good on Sir's side at all. If we check items, Innocent has a PMS, he has phase boots, but otherwise not much. Earthshaker does only has his soul ring, no boots there yet. Omi Online is trying to build into the Vanguard, but it's going to be very late. Meanwhile, Haxor's already has an urn. Loco already has phase boots and bottle. Bounty Hunter killing off Zeus again on the mid lane. Same procedure as before. Nice, this time the Fisher was correct. Oh, but Akosha isn't dying! And now look, the Decay stack's probably going to help him here. In fact, he's going to get a return kill. MTZ getting the return kill, and now they need to back off. They're so slow, though! Nice kill onto the Earthshaker. And Innocent. Will Innocent make it out of here alive? He probably will not. Nope, he even had track gold on him. What a mess. What a bloody mess. 5,000 heading to 7,500 on net worth. 4,000 heading to 5,000 on XP. And Umi is still trying to farm up. What such a shame, really. And here you go. Virfil is now the next one to die. He wanted to get his ult off, but that Fisher will not help in any way. Omni Slash is there, but it doesn't hit him. It doesn't hit the targets he wanted to. One more slash on Loco would have been dead. Ermi is there. Managed to get a kill on Loco. Hexed up Innocent, but that doesn't matter. Slark dies. Slark kills Earthshaker. The Crystal Maiden kills Slark. And here we go. Hacksaw is now being chased down by Innocent, but he'll be able to get out of this alive. Meanwhile, Umi getting a kill on the backlines on the Lion. That's a 3-man wipe already for 2. It's not bad, but the problem is those two were caught. Stop following Innocent. You can't kill him. Should have stayed by the creep wave and just killed off the creep wave. Yes, you could have gotten tracked, but whatever. Does not matter. The tunnel vision is real on Sir's side. There you go. Now Fimo is in, trying to salvage. I mean, Sir are trying to salvage anything they can right now, and it's looking like a pure domination. 18-8 on the Rhino's side, and if you check net worth once again, it's going up to 5,000 thanks to that triple killer bot, but it's very, very quickly going back down. They got the PA now. She's got her drums. She can go early fighting if she really wants to, and she has been. XP's going up again, but it's starting to plateau, so probably going to see a sharp decrease again. Ermi's now going right back in on the PA. He's only got level 3 Bristleback. He's got the level 4 now. No, he actually took a level in Nasal Goo. Unsure of that. Probably would have gotten the last level in Bristleback and then taken Nasal Goo. Just because he needs that EHP. And look, it's Wurfle on his own again. No, Innocent's actually there and he's dying off to the frickin' Tombstone. TP reactions are coming in. Will that be enough to save, to salvage something out of Rhino's situation? No, and I'm going to say no, because here comes Loco. Let's take items away. Comes Loco, and she just got Zeus. And now she's walking on the back lane. Decay is out there. Ah, ult is dropped. Oh, Loco. That's not what you wanted to do, Loco. Rock right into that ult. No, that's not something you really wanted to do. Ooh, that would have been a close. I think you could have gotten the core stack there, but no. It's gonna be an ult from Zeus, and Hacksaw really wants the kill. He does get the kill. Ermi, meanwhile, trying to decide on targets. You gotta pick something, Ermi. Getting a kill on Hacksaw, very good. Now Fimo's coming in, though, with a DD, so this looks like a kill. No! Actually, the last Quill stack coming in from Bristleback, killing the Lion first. It looks like Wurfle is now going to be in a bit of a trouble here, as Fimo is there. Ooh, should have Fissured. No, actually didn't have Fissure. Alright, then. That was a legitimate choice, then. Fimo with the DD, very scary. It's a 4 for 3, though, with gold change, with a positive gold change for Rhino Gaming. It's plateauing around 7,500, but I'm going to say sharp dip again. And as you can see, here's the dip for the XP, 4,000 heading to 5,000. L now has his Fissure, but oh, misuse. That's probably a dead L. Yep, that's a dead L. TP reactions coming in from Cactus, but this is too late to do anything. In fact, this is going to actually cost Cactus his life if he's played this wrong, but he doesn't. Wurfle is back. And Loco is farming up like a pro. Vanguard is up on Umi late, it's 13 minutes in. Innocent, meanwhile, he's getting a Robe of the Magi. I'm going to say Diffusal. No, actually, Drums. Could be Drums, could be anything, really. No, it's Drums, okay. Diffusal would not have been a bad choice, in fact. Cactus now up there. Umi is trying to fight out Fido. It looks like he's actually going to die fighting here. Are the Quill Stacks enough? No, they aren't, but Earthshaker's crit is. Innocent stunned up. Will Innocent be able to do a lot, anything in this fight? Hacksaw's there. Nice Omni Slash onto Hacksaw. He has to start spinning. Good. Zeus getting the kill. Loco's there. Nice Fissure block. Getting Loco. And now it's over. Will Loco die? Not before killing Crystal Maiden. Now MTC is the only one left alive. It's still 3-2. Undying pushing through top. No tower's gone yet, actually. That's a very positive gold swing for Sir. It's exactly what they needed. 7,500 going up to 5,000. Let's see what items are coming up, though, for Rhino. Slark is about to finish off his Shadow Blade, so that's pretty bad. Dagon is coming up. Dagon for Hacksaw. He's going full on here. Akosh has finished off his Vanguard, so he's going to be very hard to kill. MTC, not having much, but he's a Lion. He doesn't need much. He only needs those Tranquils, and that's really it. And PA, whatever she can build whatever she wants, really. She's been mid. She's got the farm she needs. They take top tower. Umi will just take down this tomb so casually. Soul Rip keeping alive for that long, but it's a Bristleback. He doesn't have to care. In fact, he'll start chasing right now. And now there's a comeback from Fimo. Fimo, in fact, going in. The ult is dropped by Zeus. Good stun by Lion. Nice Fissure by Elvo. And it looks like Loco, will he die again? Not once again, not before Crystal Maiden dies. Juggernaut, nice Echo Slam there. But unfortunately, it's not enough. Innocent is actually going to die to Fimo here. And now L is on in trouble. They lost 3 for a core, now it's 4 for a core. That net worth is good, and now this is once again the turnaround. It's 10,000. It's 10,000 for the diet. It's 10,000 for Rhino. It's about 5,000 for in XP. And that's a definite. The Shadow Blade probably winning on the fight there. The Dagon being used as well for immense burst damage. That Vanguard is also costing them a lot. Akosh is just too tanky right now. Umi's farming up. He's almost got. He's going for a BKB with that Ogre Club most likely. BKB does mean that a lot of things that Akosh are able to do, for example, Lion, Bounty, and Slark Pounce aren't going to work anymore. We will see how this works out, though. I mean, they still have the PA, who's been doing very well for herself. Finishing off Yasha, pretty good. Innocent being tracked up. Fimo is invis on the back lines, with an invis rune, not with his Shadow Blade. Innocent actually also going for a BKB here. In fact, he's going to go and start going on Cactus, who is leashed up, freezes up, and that's a good kill on CM. She's just respawned as well. That must be pretty sad for her. Going right back in on L. They know if the supports are dead, then there's nothing much they can do. And it looks like Innocent and Vofel are now stuck in a pretty bad situation for themselves. There's 5v3. Will they be able to do much? The cores are there. Ult is there. Where is Vofel? Vofel is stuck, but Ermi's there to assist. The tombstone is still there, though, and Vofel falls. No kills going on the side of Sir. Will MTC die? MTC will die to Innocent. They're trying to go in for Innocent, though. Kiakt, he pops his ult, he pops his Q, and now Ermi's on the rampage. TP's coming in from Cactus. Nice freeze there. Tracker still hits Ermi, though. And now Fimo looks like he's in a bit of trouble. Nice Quill Strike. Doesn't have the man for it, but he can hit. There you go. Ermi, being able to turn this whole fight around. Very well played from the Bristleback. And that's again, they're 10,000 behind, but it's not working well for them. They have to push up now. In fact, the fact that only 2,000, that only one tower has been taken this entire game is pretty impressive by itself. Now, they're pushing, but will they be able to find anything to push into here? Nice defense. MTZ and Haxor defending nicely. Haxor, in fact, has a level 3 Dagon already. That's going to basically burst down the CM. Mech is being built up on the Undying. A bit late for Mech, but you know what? Those Guiding Griefs are always helpful. Tower denied, so two towers down, but one of them is a deny, so less gold for Sir, unfortunately. And Umi is doing well on the net worth level. Oh, Umi? He's out. Actually, no, he's not out. Looks like they took the bait. They actually almost killed the CM ult. CM illusion. Pyma's chasing up, but he decides to back off. Do they know where Fimo is? Well, now they do. They know where L is now, and L, they should probably guess that this is a sign for wards. Oh, there you go. Yeah, no, Fimo has to back off from this. Can't fight this, and Umi is there. They don't have any sentries. They don't have any sentries. This could be a fight decided by sentries. Oh, no, Juggernaut purging off the track, and now they're chasing back Rhino. But meanwhile, PA is just farming up top. She has a Yasha. So, do they want to react to that push? Maybe send just someone back, like the problem is they can't send anyone. Maybe they could send Vofel back for he can long range with the of the Thunder God's Wrath. But here we go, Umi online is now going in. Decides to not pursue any further. The Fissure block hitting nothing. Two tracks up already on Sir. They have the sentries up, but the sentries up a bit late. No one there. They probably just want to see where the bounty is. Bounty's just going to start returning it. Oh, look at that. Look at that shuriken. Oh, Sir almost, L almost dying. His track is still up. He doesn't want to kill it. Good ult by Cactus. What an ult, but Tombstone is dropped and Akosh is going to go ham here. Undying, killing off the Juggernaut, but now Ermi wants to keep going ham. wants to keep going ham, and Fimo's on the back line trying to kill him. Does Emmy have the mana for Quill Spray? He does, in fact, have the mana for Quill Spray. Meanwhile, Loco getting a double kill up, and he's probably going to get a triple kill here. There's nothing you can do about that. 4-1 for Rhino, and this could be the match decider. That's a very huge gold swing. If we look at the recap, it's not as bad as I expected, but it's still big. That XP change was huge though. 7,500 XP going down to 10,000. Gold change is now 12,000 going down to 14,000. Probably 15,000. Mechanism finished up on the Undying. Pretty good item to get, and he's probably just going to straight up upgrade those into the Guardian's Greaves. He does have the Arcane and he does have the mech, so Guardian's Greaves it is. Loco's actually handed over his bottle to Lion, and you know what? Loco is transitioning over from the mid build to the carry build, which is completely what I expected. It's what you want to get on PA, staying with the mid build the whole time. Of course, there's two TP reactions, but this could be dangerous. Who's going to come in first? Omi's going to come in first. Who has a blink? It was Loco. Of course, blink strike. They don't want to keep pushing this. Axor has a Dagon level 4 waiting up. Guardian's Greaves, are they finished for? No, there was just slowly make sure the courier doesn't get into the path of Sir's team. The entirety of Sir is down here, and unfortunately they lost a huge amount of net worth and a huge amount of advantage. They lost the small inkling of hope they had in that last fight. It's what decided it. They went in too hard on the bounty, and the PA just cleaned up on the back lines. If we have a look, they're going to take this tier 2 for a tier 1. Are they going to take a tier 3 for a tier 2? Akosh, is he able to back off here? Actually, Akosh dies! Ooh, that was unexpected. And they kill the Tombstone easily. They need to retreat back now. They need to defend this push. Otherwise, it's going to be like the last situation. No decay is up. They have buyback on the Undying. Does he want to buyback? Tracks are starting to come up on him from Rhino. L is staying back, making sure that they can see the back pedal from Rhino. Innocent will be the last one up. Right, MTZ with his blink, trying to blink in and catch someone, but no one was there anymore. Good reactions by Sir, getting out of them immediately. Let's have a look at Loco. Yep, Loco. Bristleback is in fact building a Sergeant Yasha for more damage. Now, Fimo has a Silver Edge, and he's probably going to build up into Ascardi next. It's a good damage item, it gives him a nice amount of strength as well. So there you go. MTC doesn't really need much, like I said. He needs that blink. I mean, he has the blink, he has a bottle he got from the PA, and he has the tranquils. That's all he really needs. He can build into anything right now. To Veil, he can build into to be honest, really anything. He can build into Veil, he can build into four stuff, he can build into the Hex if he absolutely wants to. Oh, they see Haxor! Soul Rip will be there to save him though. They decided to back off. They could have actually killed him there. I believe they could. Is Haxor? Haxor is seen there. They must have seen Haxor there. They will take bot pretty easily. Fimo actually taking bot. Interesting. Haxor will start taking jungle. We'll just start taking the Radiant jungle. I mean, that's what he wants. That's what he can do. Smoke of Deceit going up onto Lion. Pretty nice item to get. Smoke ganks up, and this if they start a smoke gank initiation into a fight, that's going to be the end of this game. Oh, and a DD on the PA, that is going to be scary. Whatever's going on right now, the Sir needs to spot it fast. They know they have a smoke, and Haxor is actually seen. Where's the dust? Actually, did they have a gem? No, yes, they do. Bristleback actually picked up a gem. Alright, they are getting really annoyed at this. I mean, it's very good. They can definitely control the map with that. But now they know. Oh, PA is actually going to start try and take Rosh with that DD, but it looks like it's not exactly working out for her as she would hope to. She will take Rosh. Ah, she has a Morbid Mask though, so there you go. She's actually going to get a hotted first. Innocent, they will start taking the mid tower, and they're going to start pushing up mid. Bristleback is starting to get tanky. Rhino wants to start finishing off that Crimson Guard pretty soon. as it's a good item to get in any case. PA will have the Vegas now, so they're going to have to watch out. Can they take the tower and back off? PA has run out of DD. Umi's eating too much decay. They're backing off from the... they're definitely doing the right decision. Backing off from the tombstone. Good Echo Slam! What an Echo Slam! The ult are coming out! Good freezing field. Thymo's trying to survive, but he gets hit by an ice. And there you go. It's a 3-for-1. Do they get the gem? Where is the gem? Ooh, Loco. Loco's there. Hack smashing to get a Dagon onto Crystal Maiden. Vufla might be the next one to fall. Nice crit. So it's a 3-for-3 situation. They turn it around. Good ults coming out from Sir, but the problem is that it's not enough. Innocent is there. Nice! Killing off Loco. That's 4-for-3. In fact, Innocent has the Hex and he has an... Whoa! 5-man wipe! This is precisely what they needed. Sir, they have to fight back from a 14,000 gold lead. That getting that 5-man wipe just gave them 5,000 back. Great work from them. Everything worked out for them. The zombies were there just to make sure they could do it. Oh, tower denied. Ah, well. Akosh has been playing on point this game. L being overconfident, jumping in there. Should not have done that. They're still behind. They have to remember that. Using ult to secure. That was an obvious kill. Should not have done that. Glitched out L there. Anyway. Good fight. Innocent gaining a lot of money from that. Now, I thought he was going to go BKB. I didn't think he was going to get the Ags. Thing is, though, it's that he decided to go Ogre Club first, which is your usual on the Ags build. You want to get a point booster first. Bristleback has picked up the gem again. And in fact, he's going invis now. They should know he's there, though. They should know he's there. Yep, they know he's there. They know he's there. He's backing off. He should back off now. No way he can initiate another fight. Now, the net worth, it's going back up to 10,000. So, if they salvage this, then it's going to be a really hard match for Sir to fight. If they want to salvage this, they need another one of those perfect team fights. And Omi Online cannot be doing that when he has a... Cannot be doing that. He cannot be doing stuff like that. In fact, he just decides to D-ward. They see him and they immediately go into his situation, but he's already gone. Axo has a Dagon level 5 now, so he's going to be able to kill off the supports pretty easily. So they need to really watch out for him. Lion does not have any much in the form of items. What does Fimo have? Fimo still has an Orb of Venom, and it looks like he really is building up into that. Scotty. They need to watch out for Loco, though. They need MMKB or something to kill Loco. At least, you know, like the Silver Edge or something similar. Otherwise, they're going to end up dead. Very much dead. And there's a TP reaction coming in from Innocent to stop this push here. And he can. He's got the damage for it. But yes, Loco is in fact farming up pretty well. In fact, they're TPing mid and Vurfle will be initiated upon. Good ult, but unfortunately it's only level 2, so right now not doing too much damage. Nice jump over Umi. Umi dodging the... Oh, but the burst damage is just too much. It's a 2-for-0 right now, and that's not something they wanted happening. Grinding's Greaves are up. Guess what's happening to Dire's bottom tower. That's a huge gold swing for Rhino, though. Oh, yes, that is. It's a way bigger gold swing than I expected. That's like 3,000 gold. Where did they get 3,000 gold from? That seems quite a lot. Interesting. Oh well. Oh, it's the track gold, of course. Yes, there you go. It's a huge amount, and it's track level 2, so it's doing a lot of gold. It's giving them a lot of gold. It's giving them 1,000 per kill. It's how they're able to completely stay ahead. I know, it's hack. I mean, it's Bounty Hunter. It's that comeback hero. And Rhino will very easily take this town. There's nothing Sir can do right now to stop them. They're putting up a very good fight, but you know. Radiant's mid tower's coming up. Sometimes fights come to an end, especially in the late game. It's 14,000. 5 minute respawn timer onto the Rosh. It looks like they want to go in on Ermi now. Tracking everyone. This is not good. In fact, Innocent is not... No, Innocent. You don't want to do that. They're actually going to take down the Tombstone. So no fights on the Tombstone here. Bounty, in fact, is building up his BKB. So a lot of BKBs will be about to come up onto the Rhino side. They need... Which means Sir cannot just initiate like they did, as they did again. CM ults will not be able to do as much as she usually would. And Loco here, once he has his BKB, that CM is going to be a very dead CM. It's a shame. Sir really did show that they could come back, but a few mistakes here and there, and it's going to cost them the game, most likely. 15,000 heading down to 20,000, and on XP it's 10,000 heading down to 15,000. I mean, Sir, they've got Innocent pretty high up, but the problem is he's free and he's being led by a bounty hunter and a PA. Something he needs to really stop. Are they going to take the tier 1? Are they going to take this tier 1 easily? And yes, they probably will. No TP's coming out from Rhino. Actually, a fortification, but just to slow them down. It's that free level 1 fortification you get, so why not? Last tier 1 on the map to fall will be the top Dire Tower. Innocent is trying to farm up the cost of the Creep Wave L. Meanwhile though, Arkosh and Fino are pushing down bot, and the rest of the team is actually pushing mid, apart from Loco, who's deciding she wants to go solo on mid, on top, but you know, it's not such a good idea. Axo's finished up his BKB, and this is going to be very scary. They're tier 2 for a tier 2, most likely. Innocent TP's back to defend the mid. What is Fimer going to get? He's got a lot of gold saved up. Crystal Maiden, meanwhile, dying to the PA. L will... Still has a 2 second. He had the 5 minute time. He should have TP'd to the fountain there. And here you go. There. Everything's over for that. Sir just have to stop losing gold on the bounty hunter. They can't afford it anymore. Bountiful. Ermi online. Trying to hold on. He's got 2,800 gold stored up. I think he's going hard. It's like saying, I need more health. And that's exactly what he does need. But PA, she has the same thing. She activated a BKB for that fight, which resulted in a kill, so I guess it's okay. But now BKBs are coming up for every single hero on Rhino's side. They've got the Bounty has a BKB. Slark has a BKB. PA has a BKB. They know they need the BKBs, and that's what they're doing. Crimson Guard is up on Akosh. On Arkosh. So, he's also going to be very hard to kill. Did they have vision onto the Radiant? Yes, Hacksaw in fact does have vision. And here Ermi online is actually farming up the jungles. I'm going to say he's going straight up hard here. It makes the most sense. Considering he's got a lot of gold saved up. Or he's going buyback. Buyback into hard. Hacksaw is being punished down here. He doesn't actually have any TPs. Ooh, nice hit on Hacksaw. But they didn't know they were there. Now they do. Oh, that Dane didn't do enough, and actually that will cost Haxor's life. Ooh, but Loco wants it. Well, Loco wants it a lot. Loco will be seen, though. What did Ermi pick up? Ermi has, in fact, not picked up much at all. I don't actually see what Ermi picked up here. Picked up another gem. Oh, that can't be right. You wouldn't spend 1,000 gold for that. Doesn't make much sense, to be honest. Oh, Innocent! Knight Omni Slash onto the Crystal Maiden, onto the Phantom Assassin as well. These are kills that he really needed. Fino is trying to get something done, but it's not working. And now Innocent is showing the true power of Juggernaut. Grounding Greaves are up, but it's not going to help. The Tombstone will still fall. Nice Decay Stacks onto Akosh, and he's going to get frozen up. And now Innocent is spinning to winning here. And Akosh is taking just too much damage. Even Crimson Guard won't save him here. Fino should have gone on the supports there. He's invis now, but that won't save him much anyway. He's frozen up and Fino will fall. It's a 4-for-1. Oh, it's a 4-0. Buybacks onto the Loco. Buybacks on the PA. Buybacks on the Slark. Tier 3 down. Now they want Innocent. They want Innocent. Bad. And Innocent will fall. Verful will fall. It's a 2-2 so far in the second engagement. Umi's running, but you know what? He can. He's a Bristleback. Even those 1,000 crits won't save him. There you go. It's over. Let's see what the replay will say after that. Oh, it only shows the second engagement, unfortunately. Losing gold for Sir, of course, but that's because Bounty... Whoa! That's a gold swing, if I do say so myself. 15,000 up to 10,000, up to 7,500. What a gold swing. What an XP swing as well. That is something. That is something very good there. Well, Sir, getting the four-man wipe pretty well. Holding on. And as I said, I thought all hope was lost, but it apparently, it most definitely isn't. Even though they lost Innocent, they were able to hold on throughout that fight. What a game. What a fight. They're going to take Rosh now. And Fimo, Undying is building up into something with that Ring of Regen. Fimo building up into TP Scroll, yes. Exactly what he's building, a Loco. She could build up into anything. She could probably build up into a Bashanai. Now, Rosh is dead. Zeus does pick up a Veil of Discord though, so pretty nice for him. Veil of Discord, 4-staff on Zeus. This is a very close game. Ladies and gentlemen. Now, Fimo wants that Innocent, and Innocent will be found out. Will this be dead Innocent? It probably will be. Innocent dies, and that's their main carry down. And now, Loco is going Loco. Much pun there. Cactus is trying to get something done, but unfortunately, he will end up dead by the Slark. MTZ is short before death, but he survives. And that will lead to another 3,000 gold swing for... Yeah, there you go. That was a dip, once again. What Sir need is another fight like that one earlier. Good Omni Slash initiation into an amazing... into an amazing push, really. Veil of Discord is popped. Decay is popped. Verful will almost instantly die to the Loco here. Oh, the Fissure Block almost keeping out MTZ. But keeping out Umi Online himself. And Umi Online might end up dead here. What is going on? Break probably denying him Bristleback. Gem of Truesight is dropped. Slark will pick it up. And this will be an easy tier 3 for them. Buyback is available on Umi Online. Not so on, you know, Innocent. You know, as they like to call them. Now, what will they do? Here we go. Buybacks are coming in. Umi Online to buy back. Buys back. Imo's respawn. TPs are in. Umi decides to go man mode in, and that's what a Bristleback should be doing. Here comes the ult from Cactus, but will it bring much? No, it won't. Aegis is popped. Umi is going ham. L is dead, though. There's the ult from Verful. Where is Innocent? Innocent is there. It's a 3-1 so far. 3-2. Buyback on L. Loco. What is Loco doing? Nice. Umi getting a kill on the back line. It looks like it's going to be a team wipe. Is it going to be a team wipe? It's going to be a team wipe. Is it going to be a team wipe? Is it going to be a team wipe? Is there any team wipe? It's a team wipe! Team wipe for Sir! Something they sorely needed. That's interesting though. It's still a 5-4. Gold change actually going heavily the way. What is this? This can't be just because of track gold, right? Okay, something seems woefully off here. That was 2,515 gold advantage for Rhino. I feel like something's wrong there. I mean, they weren't all tracked. I mean, even if they were all tracked. Huh. Someone should do the math for me, please. Something seems woefully off there. Now, Bounty Hunter does have level 3 track. I believe. Yeah, it's 350. Yes, but net worth is overtaken by Innocent, actually. Innocent, who has decided to buy an MKB. Good choice there. Now let's see what the respawns are. MTC with the Necrobook, so he's going full push. And now, though, two cores are in the base, and they want to take down these barracks. Barracks will fall. Range barracks will fall. Inno doing his absolute damnedest best. Now Inno is eating a lot of burst, but Inno doesn't care. He's going to start just less once again. What the heck, sir? I told you, sir had the late game pretty secure. The PA is dead, so there's nothing she can do there. And that final will probably end up dead here. Oh, nice stun there by NTC though. Umi, will he be able to get out? He will. In fact, Loco's now going to start chasing. But he won't be able to catch anyone. Actually, he will. They do see L, who is tracked. And Innocent is coming up to support the L. But Innocent will back off. Doesn't want to get tracked. Nice stun there. And he will blink out. Innocent will back off. Fimo chasing after him with the Silver Edge. But will he be able to catch? No. In fact, the Dire mid-range backs have been destroyed as well by just creep push. Two racks down for Dire. They are ranged, of course. You have to remember that. But it's still two racks versus none. In a game where they are actually favored. Whoa! The XP is going back up to zero. I'm going to expect that's because Loco's about to hit level cap. No, in fact, it's not. Let's check hero levels quickly. Level cap. In fact, if anyone's going to reach level cap, it's going to be Innocent. He's 23 up. On net worth, he's also leading, and he's going to keep that lead. And that gold swing is back up to 7,500. It is dipping. The valleys are starting. What Sir cannot allow themselves to do is to get overconfident. And yes, Umi is building built straight up into a heart. Exactly what he needed. Let's see what Fimo has. Fimo is building up into the Skadi. It's a slow build-up, of course. He has the 2,100 for the second ultimate orb, so it should be finished pretty much soon. MTC, meanwhile. There's another DD on VA. She doesn't have a Battle Fury, though, so no huge crits hitting the area. However, it is still a scary sight to see. Hexor's main damage item right now is only a Dagon level 5. If you want to put it that way. Killing the supports, easy. Actually, not so much anymore. The supports are starting to build up health. Know that. Ghost Scepter is actually up on Virful. He doesn't want to get killed by Loco anymore. Ah, here we go. Initiation from Loco. Virful decides that he doesn't want any more of this shit. He doesn't actually get his ult off, though. That could be a mistake. Loco kills him. Slark kills Crystal Maiden. Innocent and Umi are now in a bit of a situation. Innocent goes down. Well, Umi goes down. This is a five-man wipe for Rhino. No. No, sir. This is exactly what you should not have done. Buybacks from both Innocent and Crystal Maiden. How is that going to help? Only Hexor is dead. And once again, this proves Sir going overconfident is now going to end up dead. So Rhino have to push through now. Yes, chat, I am aware that it was two buybacks for Sir, but it still shouldn't have been still 2,000 gold swing does seem like a huge amount. 2,800, I believe it was even 3,000 gold swing. Excessive amount, almost. Still a five-man wipe on a team that was clearly dominating. Now, Loco wants to charge in on Verfalem. They're going to take the range racks. Are they going to take the lead racks as well? Actually, no. Glyph is up. Do they wait for Umi to respawn, or do they just go in right now? Can they go in right now? Can they allow? The ult is down, and here comes the Omni Slash. Loco is stunned up. Omni Slash hitting Akosh. Akosh will be the first to fall here. And in fact, by now, Serv only lost one range racks. So, that's good for them. Innocent. Will secure another kill, and in fact he's got BOTs and a basher now, so that's pretty good. Meanwhile, MTC is getting the second level of his Necronomicon, so that's going to be a lot of split push. Fimo, yeah, the Skadi's going to go up soon. He's lost a lot of gold from the death, I'm going to say. Or he has it in his stash. Yes, he does. No, it would have been weird. He didn't actually die yet, so... EA decided to go BOTs for the global presence. In fact, most players have gone BOTs for the global presence. There's already two BOTs I see up on the Rhino, one BOT up on Sir. Global presence is there. They don't see Hacksaw yet. There's Rhino. Nice stun, and now they want to get Innocent before he's able to do much. Well, they're just seeing B-able. There you go. He's still able to get the Omni Slash off. There's the ult. Loco will fall, as will Lion. Undying is about to return. Healing Ward is up, and now they will start pushing again. Fighting once again from behind. 3,000 gold swing for Sir. It's going to play. It's another valley. PA is bought back, but you know what? Sir don't have Omni Slash yet. It's in a minute of cooldown. Do they need Omni Slash to fight this? No, there's too many of them. Luka would die if he tried to fight this. Akosh, does he have ult? He has ult and he has Tombstone. Is he able to go in? Sir is actually going to start backing off here. Exactly what they need to do here. They can't fight under Tombstone. Axel's going in and not being able to do as much damage as he probably would have. But it doesn't matter. Every bit is good and the track cold will be there. Scuddy's up on Fimo, so that's also going to be pretty scary. Tombstone will remain up for another about, I'm going to say, about 5 to 10 seconds. And now Innocents, they can't allow them to fight. And here we go. Tombstone is now out, and now this is the time when they should push. There's a 30 second cooldown on Tombstone. This is it. This could be the fight to decide the game, ladies and gentlemen. Very interesting. It's going to be a pretty... Is this going to be a standoff? Is this going to be a fight? Arcos is bot waiting out the cooldown. I guess. Right then. I stand corrected by Vincent Vega. Thanks to you. Pushing into the racks here. When is Tombstone going to be up? Tombstone is actually back up right now. BKBs are popped. So are ults. Hacksaw trying to get Vrifil, but Vrifil not going down. Cactus will he be the first to fall? Cactus will be the first to fall. Nice Echo Slam. What an Echo Slam. The zombie's just securing it. Innocent, will he die here? Innocent will die. This could be it, ladies and gentlemen. Sir have probably just lost the game. That's four men for once again. 5,000 gold swing for Sir, for Rhino. Bounty Hunter buying back. They need, that's the final push. This is the final push. I believe that Sir, that last fight probably may have cost them the game if Rhino played their cards right. And I expect Rhino to play their cards right. They have been doing so most of the game. Although, to be honest, playing away that advantage, Sir did play well. And will they play well here? They have a buyback on Omi. They have 20 seconds on the CM. Good Fisher block blocking off, but Fiber will, but their blinks are still there. And now they're gonna go in. Verifel will probably be the first one to fall here. Amelia Rex will also fall pretty quickly here. Yep, there go Amelia Rex, and this is going straight to the top Rex. It's one set of racks down for Sir, the second set of racks about to fall. Top racks ain't gonna last so long for the Radiance. And there we go. Two racks down for Sir. I believe this is it. Third rack's about to fall as well. Ult is dropped by Zeus, but will it make a difference here? Loco does not have too many health items. Fimo, however... No good old drop by Cactus, but will it do much? No, in fact, because Bounty Hunter will kill off the Earthshaker. And there's Decay. Loco killing off the CM in the back. Vrifil about dead, but not really dead. And now Lino's going to come back, so they still have a set of racks left. Although, what are they waiting for? Bonomi's dead here, dead in the water. Inno's about to TP in, and it's the die? No, Omni Slash. He gets off the Omni Slash on Fimo, and Fimo will die. In fact, Umi has bought back, and that does mean a 3,000 gold swing to 4,000 gold swing for Team Rhino. That's down to 20,000, the most net worth that has been differed in this game. Innocent's still top of the net worth, but that's not going to help if the rest of the team is stuck behind, and considering, and also if the rest of the team starts at 5, position 6 of the net worth graph. Axel does not want the global presence to happen. He's just like, zap. And Innocent is saying that's not kind of me. F creeps, am I right? Dagon OP. Anyway. I don't know if Sir can really salvage the situation. They're two racks down. They have no tier 3s left. Their net worth is down the gutter now. And their XP is also down the gutter. Let's look at levels. Rosh has actually just been taken again, once again, by PA. Cheese will be picked up by the MTZ, I'm gonna say. No, actually, Cheese will not be picked up. Will be kept up by the courier. Let's check the, not the GPM, we can check the GPM, it doesn't look too good. I mean, there you go, Inn is pretty number one, followed by PA. Nothing much to say there. Hero level is what I wanted to see. Two heroes have reached their level cap, so the XP graph should start stabilizing as well. Yep, Fimo is about to reach level cap, so once again, the XP graph should start stabilizing pretty soon. And, ladies and gentlemen, we're probably going to go into the first 60-minute game tournament if it continues for the next 9 minutes. Let's hope it doesn't. Well, let's hope it does. Depends, really. Could be interesting. Sir is forced back to the base, but we'll see. They've been fighting from behind this whole game, and they've managed to drag it out to 50 minutes. It's pretty good. Don't you know, I'm Loco is, however, farming up pretty well, has an Abyssal Blade, so that means Inno will be unable to just perform as he did earlier. That Wild Renrica is not going to bring you anything. Really, it won't bring you anything at this stage of the game. There's two sets of racks down for Sir, but you know what I forgot to mention is that there's also one and a half set of racks down for Team Rhino, so to be honest, it could be... Sir could be seeing some comebacks here. Solar Crest is up on Undying, and so is of Lads. I forgot to mention his items. We actually haven't looked at items in ages. He has an Ultimate Orb, which I'm going to guess is going to be for... I don't think he's going to get a Scaly. That wouldn't make much sense. Yeah. Probably going to be a Hex or a Lincoln's. Most likely it's going to be a Hex. Fimo, in the meantime, has built himself his own Basher. Haxor has built himself a Desolator. So a lot of very scary items coming up onto Rhino Gaming's side. Lion has a level 3 Necro, and that's all he... I mean, like I said, it's all he really needs. He's got the wards as well, so there you go. Meanwhile, on Sir's side, I see two Aghanims. I see a heart. To be honest, these items are kind of really... are really behind what Rhino Gaming has. Earthshaker has a point booster trying to build up into... what I'm guessing is going to be a Bloodstone. But you know what, that doesn't make too much sense on an Earthshaker. I mean, really, the second Aghanims doesn't make much sense, so he's probably going to be building up into a Soul Booster. And that can build up into an Octarine Core or a Bloodstone, so... I'm not sure. Will he be building a Bloodstone, maybe? But it doesn't seem like the best of ideas. Maybe it's just a casual point booster. Umi is getting targeted, but you know what? The thing is, he's getting hexed so much, it's not even funny. He needs a BKB. He needs a BKB desperately. Abyssal is up on Juggernaut. He can use that during Omni Slash, which is pretty nice. In fact, the Juggernaut is actually farming up on top. Trying to get some much needed last hits. Yes. Like I said, some very scary items coming up onto Rhino's Gaming side. If so, cannot defend this push, and it looks like they won't be able to. Here we go, Loco's in first, and he's only going to... pops his BKB, and it's killing off one after the other. Ult is popped, but there goes Umi. And I think that's it. Do you notice Loco isn't even dying to the ult? He actually does die, but it's got Aegis. Innocent starts the Omni Slash. Oh, what a nice Omni Slash! Loco, however, cleaning up on the back line, and I think this is GG. There goes the last set of racks. Inno dies to the Dagon. Cactus is dead. Riffle is dead. Innocent. Fimo just eating up the cheese. Innocent doing whatever he can. GG, well played, coming out from Sir Rhino. Both of those teams just incredibly well played. Have to say. So, we'll unfortunately drop out of the tournament. Rhino Kumite Gaming will continue to the next phase, which will be the semi-finals, which we will be showing you guys tomorrow. The winner of those semi-finals will go into the finals, and the finals, whoever wins the finals will be able to play against My Insanity in our offline event. Bear in mind, this is the Swiss My Insanity team, not the Bulgarian My Insanity team. Still a very good team. I encourage you to tune in onto the final to see who has the chance of playing against My Insanity. And subsequently, if they have the chance to be able to represent Switzerland in the European Swiss Championships. No, I think it's actually the World Championships, the World Dota 2 Championships. Bear in mind, this is not the international, just the World Dota 2 Championships. Anyhow, that was Sir, ladies and gentlemen. Apparently both of these teams were Sir. Sir versus Rhino, ladies and gentlemen. Until tomorrow at about 12, we will be start streaming the semi-finals. Both of them will be best of three, and subsequently the finals, which will be as well a best of three. Until tomorrow, ladies and gentlemen. This has been Morality Clause. I will keep the stream running with some rock music.